she actually reached, like, we had a recliner in the living room, reached and grabbed after the bat, and kind of, you know, hit me, you know, broadside me or whatever. Kids, yeah, they're asleep. Where do they sleep at now? The boys have a bedroom, and then the two girls sleep in the living room area.
Okay. So when I've been to the house, I went to the house earlier today. When I walk in the front door, obviously you walk in, you're in the living room,
mm-hmm.
right? And then there's a bedroom to the right.
Mm-hmm.
Closest to the road.
Yes.
Is that the boys. That's the boys' room?
Yes, sir.
Okay, and then the other room on the other end of the house is obviously y'all's, right?
Yeah.
Okay. And there was nothing left in the house as far as furniture or anything. Where was the chair at, situated in the house?
You first walked into the house. The recliner was right there to the left.
Okay. Where'd that recliner go?
I left it there.
Okay.
Yeah, I didn't take it.
Okay.
Yeah, I didn't take much out of there. So then it's summer, so the boys, her boys end up going with her father for a couple of weeks. So I have the girls. Just me and the girls.
When did you take the boys to dad?
You know, they came back before the weekend before the 22nd. And they were gone for about 10 days, so maybe the 12th of August or so.
Okay, that's when they went to dad's, about the 12th, so a day or two after this happens. What did you do?
School's, you know, approaching. Boys come back.
How do the boys end up back there, dude? I mean, obviously dad would normally call, text. How would that happen?
It was previously with a drop off. It was determined what time, you know, what day, time frame was up in the air. So he texted, and I went and picked him up.
Okay. So he texted. You or text her, or what's you guys' relationship like as far as with him?
We haven't talked much. Not really any relationship there. You know?
Okay, so it's
really
not,
no communication. Yeah.
Okay. So just I got the boys. Where do you guys meet?
We met at the Lake Square Mall, Leesburg Mall.
Okay. Where does their dad live?
He's lived in Florida for a while. He moved here a couple of years ago.
Okay.
And they've been going back and forth as far as custody goes and when he can have him or if he can't. And he just kind of fell off the face of the earth and came back into the picture.
Really? So you get them back about the end of August?
Yeah. I know school's starting.
Are we talking about the beginning of August? Because I think school starts like August 12th or something like that, if I remember correctly. August 11th or something like that.
Yeah, school starts around then. It was like the 10th.
Okay.
So
they're with dad for about a little less than a month, right?
Yeah. I think they were there for, like I said, I think 10 days or 2 weeks.
Does he text her phone? Does he text your phone? How does that work?
I believe at first he texted her phone.
Okay.
I think we communicated the second time through my phone.
Okay.
May have been through her phone.
And obviously at that point you got to keep up some sort of ruse that you're her, right?
Right.
Okay. So what happens then? You go and get the boys? You go all to Lake City and get the boys?
No. Met back up at the mall in Leesburg.
Okay.
His parents live somewhere in Florida.
Okay.
And then I think it's about a week.
Where are the girls at this time?
They were back with me at that point. I had dropped them off at my mother-in-law's.
Miss Nikki?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. And I think I had them back.
So you get the boys back from dad, and school starts, school's going on for about a week.
Yeah,
what school do they go to?
I enrolled in Fruitland Park Elementary.
Okay. Because you worked down there?
I never go. Well, we lived in Leesburg.
Okay.
The last school year.
Okay.
And ended up getting, we didn't want to put them in Leesburg, we should want to put them in Leesburg, so we ended up putting them in Fruitland Park.
Okay. Did you ever take them to school?
No, not this year.
So they were enrolled in Fruitland Park but never made it.
Right.
Okay. And then what happens with them? go, are you going to work still?
Yeah, I work, I work under the table for a guy right now.
Up in Jacksonville?
No, in the Villages.
So you're driving
back? Down here, yeah, work a couple of days.
Okay. Yeah. Are you driving the van back and forth?
Yeah.
Are you driving Sarah's car? Or?
No, okay.
Obviously, I have to ask it. I got some pictures of the inside of the house from when the cleaning people showed up to clean everything up. And it looked like you were getting ready to pack up to move, right?
Yeah, I mean, a lot of our stuff was still packed up.
From moving there?
Yeah.
How long had you guys lived there?
I moved in April.
Okay. So April, May, June, and then July is when everything happened.
Yeah.
So just a couple months.
Yeah.
What's you guys' relationship like? I mean, is this an ongoing thing where you guys are at each other like this, like fighting, or?
It just got worse. Like, you know, little things all the time with her should come at me. And, we argue and, you know, never really got physical. We had 13 people living with us in Leesburg.
Really?
Nikki, my mother-in-law, my sister-in-law, and my sister-in-law's 6 kids with our 4. And it was pretty tumultuous. I mean, it was rough. To where we had to call the police on Nikki, actually. And she slapped her granddaughter across the face. And just things got out of hand. But we were in the process of selling the house pretty much for 9 months or so. And the first bid that she got, first offer she got, we packed up, so stuff had been in totes for.
Okay. Was that your house down there?
Oh, it was hers. It's my wife's.
That was your wife?
Yeah.
That was Casey's house?
Yeah.
The, what was that address? 12?
Yeah, 20. 2018 Vine, yeah.
Vine Street, okay.
Yeah.
So you're staying with Sarah. Is Sarah asking about the babies and what's going on, or?
No, I mean, I would keep the kids, and she would, you know, go to work, and on the weekends, do Uber and stuff like that, and so there wasn't much conversation about it, you know, here and there, but, you know, I would tell her that, you know, Casey and I are separated, and she's with her mom right now, so.
Okay. So you kind of just covered that
first, yeah.
And did she think much of it? Was she excited that you were back? Are you guys dating again, or?
No dating. She has a boyfriend of a couple of years, and he's up in Vermont. Nothing.
Okay, so you're just kind of crashing there
yeah.
and spending time with the kids.
Yeah.
Okay.
And, well, I was there for the hurricane for that week. You know, just thought, hey, you should come stay with us. And you're in a trailer, and, you know, I told her that the girls were with their mother. And, you know, she said, well, come stay with us because, you know, they're freaked out. They just moved down here a few months ago. Okay. Nothing happened in the hurricane, obviously, but I still stayed there.
And her boyfriend was there at that time?
No. He's
okay.
He lives in Vermont.
So you got pretty much, she's under the impression that Casey was staying with mom and
yeah.
the kids are all healthy and everything's good.
Yeah.
Let me ask you this. Does Nikki and her sisters and everybody start calling? What's going on with the phone? I know she's got a phone, right?
Yeah, she had her phone, so I had her phone for a while, and I would text and pretend to be Casey. And
what's Casey's phone number?
352-360-8140.
Okay, and what, do you know what provider that is?
Yeah, it's Sprint.
Okay. What's your cell phone number? Or what was your cell phone number until recently?
352-530-9730.
Okay. And so you're pretending this whole time to be Casey on, obviously on Facebook too, because you got some like collages that you made or something on Facebook and
yeah.
posted yeah. them. And
also Sprint for your yours.
Yeah, same. It's another same.
So then you're answering text messages back and forth, and
yeah, so
that's tough, man.
And I trashed her phone. I don't know what day it was, but I was actually down up by the city hall, looking down at the police department, which I believe is Marion County Police Department.
Okay.
I sat there for several hours with my daughters, and turn myself in, you know. Smashed her phone in that day and threw it in the dumpster.
City Hall, I'm trying to think.
Is that...
Maybe Bellevue?
Like, yeah, maybe
by the Checkers?
Yeah, Wells Fargo's over there or something.
Yeah, maybe. There's a Checkers and a Wells Fargo,
yeah.
And you kind of look down the hill at the police department. Okay. Is it... Did you throw it in the trash? Did you throw it in the bushes?
No, I threw it in a dumpster. It was adjacent from... it was across the street from City Hall. Across the road.
Across 441?
Yeah. Looked like an old gas station or something like that.
What stops you from turning yourself in? Just this basic fear that, you know, you're going to end up in the situation you're in right now.
Yeah.
Now, are you driving around in the van this whole time? I have to go back to, you didn't dispose of anything out of the house. Did you clean it? Do you drink?
I drink beer, yeah.
Drugs or anything?
No.
I'm
on medication, but...
Are you on medication right now?
Mm.
What type of medication are you on?
Blood pressure medication, and then I have a medication for depression, Wellbutrin.
Okay. Is that affecting the way you're thinking or anything right now? You seem to be pretty level-headed.
Yeah, I don't...
out of your house.
Yeah.
Go south.
Right, go south. Probably 2 miles, maybe.
It's before you hit the Walmart?
Before Walmart.
Before the Walmart.
Before 42?
Before 42, yes.
Before 42. Okay. Okay.
And is that, I mean, do you think it's still there? Or do you think they've had a trash pickup come since then?
I would assume they had it.
It's not been within the last week, obviously, because
no.
You ain't been here. So.
Oh.
Okay. So you cleaned all that stuff up, and is there, can you share with us her, Casey's Facebook name?
Her Facebook name?
Yeah. Is it
Princess? Yeah, it's Casey Princess.
What's her password for Facebook?
I do not know.
How did, so you just logged out because it was on her phone?
Yeah, she kept it open.
So
where's your phone at?
The deputy took it.
Is that the same phone? You still have the same phone from all that time, you just don't have any minutes on it?
Right. It bill's overdue and they turned it off a couple days ago.
Okay. So that's why when I called you a couple times it went straight to voicemail?
Yeah.
Okay. So obviously you were staying with Sarah. Were you with her last night?
I was up there, yes.
Okay. Up there at her place?
Yeah, up in Jacksonville.
Is she staying in apartments?
Yeah, she has apartments.
Did you guys hear my phone call and stuff last night? What was the deal with all that?
She woke me up early morning and asked me what was up with, you know, is there any reason why Marion County would be, you know, looking for you? And then I just tried to spin stuff, and finally, I said, you know what, let me just get on the road. So.
Did you tell her what in the heck was going on?
No.
She told us that when you talked to me, or when she talked to me this morning, you were still there. Is that true?
When she spoke to you on the phone? Yeah, I was there.
What was going on?
Just trying to figure it out.
You were trying to figure out what I had going on? And
yeah.
Did she talk to you? Did you tell her what to say to me, or?
No, one point, she thought it was looking for just me, and so I said, you know, if you've seen me or whatever, you've seen Casey, you've seen everybody, you know. So, yeah, I guess I did tell her.
Okay, so basically, what was the deal with the McDonald's? She mentioned something about being at McDonald's. She met you at McDonald's on Friday or something to exchange the kids.
Oh, that's usually a meetup spot.
Okay, so that's your usual meetup spot.
We're going halfway. Okay.
So, after that phone call, how long after that phone call do you leave?
I don't think I left out of Jacksonville until like 3.
So you were there for a while. After I called her the first time, I mean, did you ever tell her exactly what was going on, or you just kind of, I gotta get out of here?
Yeah, I just told her I gotta get out of here.
Did you get out of there after I called the second time?
Around that time, yeah, because she'd come back. She left the house and come back. And we talked about, you know, why'd you have me tell them this? And, you know, they're calling me back. I said, well, you know, let me try and go deal with it. So.
And you called me, right?
I did call you.
Why did you come? What do you think was going to happen today after you left? What was the plan?
The only thing really I hadn't planned was just to get out of Florida for now, or cross the border here and set a rest up and, you know, try and think. I'd like to say that, you know, sit here and kill myself, but, you know, that's not it, you know, just running.
So whenever I got that, whenever that second call came in, it was, you knew it was probably time to get going.
Yeah.
and you left and didn't really have a plan because obviously you weren't planning for detectives to start calling you. Did you see any information about them missing or anything?
No, I didn't see anything. She told me that there was some stuff on Facebook.
Sarah did?
Yeah, Sarah did.
Does Sarah communicate with Casey's family?
No.
So it would have had to been something that we posted or something like that?
Yeah, well, I think it was something that was reposted.
Okay.
Through family members. She's Facebook friends with my mother and stuff.
Okay.
I assume they...
Did you call your mom at any point and tell her what the heck was going on as far as...
No, my relationship with my mother's been rocky for a long time.
Okay.
I try to keep it, you know, together as much as possible, but I message her, you know, a couple times a week, but other than that, I haven't actually spoke to my mother in a long time. To hear her voice, so...
So you get up here into Georgia, what maybe is there any family, any friends, anybody that's this way? That
no.
So you're just driving. You got money to go anywhere?
No, I had, you know, $40 when I left, and so I figured I put some money in the tank and drove, and figured I'd get across the border, like I said, into Georgia, and sort of rest up and think, you know, before people came after me.
Yeah.
So you pulled down this road here, and at what point did you decide what you were going to do with that?
I'm driving, and I just keep seeing, you know, pull-offs, and I was like, I don't even know. Like, it didn't cross my mind, really, other than just the pull-off. So I pulled off, went down the road, took a piss.
mean, obviously they don't train that. Are you, were you ever in the military?
Yeah, I was.
What branch?
I was in Navy.
Okay. For how long?
5 years. Served with the Marines in the medical field. But, yeah, no, I'm not trained.
You were in the medical field, though?
Yeah.
You kind of had an idea of things that you could do.
Tell me about this. This is another question I had. How did you wreck the van? What happened there?
Like I said, after I got out of the woods driving or whatever, the GPS is like rerouting me, and so I'm messing with the GPS, and it's touch screen, and I'm looking this way, and I swerved off the road once, and then kind of like, okay, pay attention. And I swerved again, and it just, that was it. Just kept going down. And I slammed into that, and that was it.
What happened then?
I got out, trying to collect myself and figure out, you know, what was up.
Hmm? Were you injured?
No. I mean, my ankle a little bit, and other than that, no, I had a seatbelt on.
You got to see up here. Is that, you got
I
a little...
I think so, yeah. No, I haven't seen myself, but yeah. Said I had some.
A seatbelt, yeah.
But I,
I wonder what that was.
Yeah.
I got, you know, the powder or whatever it was in my eye. It was burning a little bit, so I got out and found something to wipe my face, and, you know, people driving by, and I was telling them, all right. And I knew that my phone would at least call 911, so I called 911. I didn't know where I was. I saw two different road signs. I said, I'm in between here.
How'd you call 911 to with your phone?
Oh, I guess
emergency. Yeah, that's right. Yes, 911, yes.
So you call 911 and you wait for the troopers to show up?
Mm-hmm.
What happens then?
Did anybody else ask you about the smell of a van while you were driving around? It had to have been overpowering. Could you smell it?
Yeah, I smelled it.
Yeah.
And mothballs in there. It broke open, and there was some of her stuff or whatever broke open in there. And that made a weird smell, like, just clung to my clothes, the mothball, and obviously the decay. And so I believe Sarah asked me once, you know, what's that smell?
And what'd you tell her?
I just said there's mothballs in there. Because yeah. I was almost overpowered the other smell on me, anyways.
How'd the window of the van get busted?
That was prior to all of this happening. I backed into a tiny little oak tree in Nikki's, my mother-in-law's driveway.
When any of these happened, were you drinking?
Mm.
No, you weren't drinking a bit. No alcohol, no drugs, no nothing.
No.
Clear head.
Different, right? I'm not going to find out that this was some plan thing. I don't think it was, but obviously, you know, I got to go back and talk to her.
Yeah, that sucks for her.
Because you already put her in a spot today.
Yeah. But she knows nothing about it. Nobody does.
Nobody at all. There's nobody that you confided in that said, you know.
I don't have anybody.
What happened with you and your mom? I know your mom called me and she told me that you called her and told her some weird story. She didn't think much of it, but obviously thinking back now, she said it was a little weird. What did you tell your mom?
I don't know. I guess telling her the same thing that I was telling the kids, like, or no,
something about Kentucky. What your mom told me.
Oh, yeah, that was from the hurricane or whatever. So she asked what we were doing if we were staying in, you know, in Florida or whatever. And that's when I was with Sarah. So I told them, no, we're going to head up to Kentucky. Casey has family up there. We've been there before. So that was the story I told.
So that wouldn't have been an abnormal story for your mom to have heard.
Right.
But you never went to Kentucky, obviously.
No.
I know I asked them, I don't remember if you answered.
feel like I dropped something in there, but I don't know.
Were they clothed or unclothed or?
The baby had a diaper on. So I guess she would be naked.
The other one's wearing.
Cameron had some bottoms on and no shirt.
You saying like shorts or something, sleeping shorts or something?
Yeah.
Is it Preston?
I think the same goes for Preston.
Okay. Well, what about the oldest girl?
She had clothes on.
You left a computer at Sarah's house.
Mm-hmm.
What's on that computer? Anything?
No, that's it was Casey's, but there's nothing on it.
Yeah. Why'd you leave it there?
So she could have the boys use it.
Okay. So you gave it to Casey for the boys.
All
right. I'm sorry, you gave it to Sarah for the boys.
Yeah.
All right, step out for a few minutes if you want.
Yeah, make sure we covered everything. And
hang tight.
Yeah. I appreciate it, Michael. Obviously, we have to ask you. You know, we traveled a long way and all that stuff. We hadn't been talking to you or anything. Is there anything in the van that's going to be of any, you know, as far as evidence is concerned? Is there anything that you used to clean up? Is there anything?
No, I mean, I do have cleaner in the car. It's just using the spray to keep the smell down.
I can smell that car for 50 feet after it sat there. Did nobody ever say anything to you about that? So you parked it in her apartment complex and it sat overnight and nobody said anything?
Never.
Could you smell it when you walked out in the morning?
Once you got up to it, right before you opened it, I smell it.
You're driving, obviously you're riding with the windows down.
Yeah. So there's some cleaner in there that I sprayed just to keep the smell down.
Mothballs are in there.
Yeah. There's fly spray in there. Flies obviously were flying around. There's two knives in there, but I didn't use anything like that.
Okay, so there's no, when we go and obviously we got a lot of stuff to process and look through. We're not going to find anything other than, there was nothing.
No, I didn't use anything other than what I said.
Okay. What was the phone number that you called me from this morning?
That's my oldest, Sarah's phone.
Okay.
She asked me to call you. You know, she was panicking and freaking out and getting. So,
understand.
Made a quick call just to appease her, and then start getting my belongings around.
What were you gonna do if I answered the phone?
Tell you I'd come see you.
And then I'll ask the other direction.
Probably.
Okay. I understand that. So I've been dealing with these guys for a couple hours now since I've been up here. Everybody been nice to you?
Yeah.
Anybody threaten you?
No.
Everything that you told us tonight has been voluntary. Nothing was coerced. Nobody threatened you in any way.
No.
This is one of those things where you're caught and it's over. Are you thinking about hurting yourself?
No, I mean, think about it, but
you're not gonna.
I can't choke myself. Probably if I owned a gun, I would, probably would have quick and fast, but I don't own a gun.
Appreciate that. Mm-hmm. You have any questions for me? They're gonna charge you tonight with whatever charges they have up here, and you're gonna have a warrant to come back to Marion County. They're gonna transport you back there eventually. Okay.
Okay. So stay here until that happens.
I don't know how long that'll take. Sometimes it's a couple of weeks, sometimes it's a couple of days. It all depends on transport, stuff like that. So. All right.
Where's Marion County Jail?
Where's Marion County Jail?
Yeah, I mean, where I go from?
What do you mean?
Like, where do I, after being charged here and you said I'm getting transported, where am I? Is it Marion County?
Yeah, okay. Marion County Jail. If you have any questions when you get down there, you can write me a letter or whatever you need to do, and I'll come over and see. Okay.
Yeah.
If there's anything else you can think of. So there's nothing buried in the yard, there's nothing hidden underneath the trailer or anything like
that?
No.
That was my only thought, was I was going to just stick them under there, under the trailer.
Did you think of
my medication?
Okay, that's all that's left in the car. What is it? I seen it's like personal property. Is there? Is that your stuff?
Yeah. Some of it's yeah, it's ours. Yeah.
Okay,
it's ours.
All right, Michael.
Yeah.
Good luck to you.
All right.
Sorry, you know. I appreciate your time. Thank you for answering all my questions.
All right. You're welcome.